Hi Sevens, here we are again with another reading of Sunny. We're going to do things a little bit differently than we normally do them. Today I'm just going to have a audio recording of me reading as opposed to making a video just because I wanted to try something a little differently today and hopefully you guys like it. So here we go, we'll start off with a recap. So we read a lot during our last class together. We read, 7 pages I think. It was a lot of back and forth between Sunny and Daryl, and mostly what the chapter focused, or the section that we read focused on, was Sunny's practice. The last practice that he had with his track team before the big track meet, which in the book takes place tomorrow. So Daryl drove Sunny to his practice, where Sunny had to pretty much spend the entire practice throwing his discuses and trying to perfect his routine. And that's basically all that really happened, but what was really nice was during the time that Sunny was practicing, he was really encouraged by everybody who was there, all of his teammates, his coaches, and his dad. They were all encouraging him and, you know, cheering him on and helping him out when he was struggling or when he maybe wasn't feeling so good about his throws. They were all encouraging him. They're all being very kind to him and helping him out and making him feel very comfortable. Sonny kind of left us off with a bit of an interesting quote, too, at the end of the reading, where he said that he didn't really care too much about winning. And I had asked you guys to, what do you think Sonny cared about? A few of you gave me some pretty interesting answers. Like one that I really liked was maybe Sonny doesn't care so much about winning, but he cares about the people that are supporting him. He cares about, you know, doing well for them and putting on a show for them and all of that sort of stuff. Basically, Sonny just wants to make sure that he does well for all of his teammates, for his coaches, and for his dad. He wants to impress all of these people and Aurelia, Gramps, everybody that he knows in his life, he wants to make them proud of him. And so we'll start with the next reading here on page 142. Here we go. Dear Diary, after all that throwing, I was starving, and for once was looking forward to getting home and snatching a TV dinner from the freezer, opening the box, poking holes in the plastic cover with the fork, and then microwaving that thing into a steamy, weird-smelling meal. Yum. But Daryl had other plans. He ended up taking me to the Chinese restaurant him and my mother went to on their first date, which happened to also be the same Chinese restaurant me and Lou and Ghost and Patty and Coach went to on our first date, back when the season was just getting started and Coach was trying to get us newbies to bond, back when we shared secrets, when I found out about Patty's mom and Ghost's dad, and how Lou always wanted a brother, back when I started sharing my own secret about my mother dying and being forced to run by the man who was now sitting in front of me, flipping through a Chinese food menu the same way he flips through the newspaper on Sundays. When the waiter came over to take our orders, I let mine rip. Peking duck and a cherry coke. And before the waiter could say that we don't have cherry coke, I told him that I knew that they didn't have it, so that a coke with a little cherry juice in it was fine. Daryl just shook his head. He ordered sweet and sour chicken and asked me where I learned about the Peking duck. I told him Aurelia orders it sometimes for lunch. He nodded and said my mother used to order that too. Said it was one of her favorite dishes, that and sausage biscuits. My cherry coke came out. I took a sip. It was delicious. Diary, remind me to thank Patty tomorrow. Anyway, that first sip brought up an idea, especially since I didn't really know what to talk to Daryl about. Besides random comments about chopsticks and my mother, things were pretty awkward. Not in a bad way, but in a way that made me keep moving around on my side of the booth, trying to get comfortable on the sweaty vinyl. So I did the only other thing I could think of. I asked Daryl if he could tell me a secret. Then I had to repeat the request. And finally, after saying, a secret, he told me why he made me call him Daryl and not Dad. He said he didn't feel like he could truly be a dad without my mother, and that it just didn't feel right. Like, I'm his son and he's my father, but she would never be able to hear me call her mom, so he just felt like it was unfair for him to be called Dad. He also admitted that maybe that's not a good reason, but it's the truth. I was supposed to be the biggest return. Hearing Mommy and Daddy was supposed to be the ultimate ROI, return on investment, the greatest moment in their plan. I asked him if he wanted me to call him Dad. He asked me if I wanted to. I told him I didn't think so, then asked him if that made him sad. He asked me if I hated him. I said, of course not. Then Daryl is fine. Cool. Now, your turn. Tell me a secret. At first I thought about telling him about you, Diary, about how I still talk to you through writing, and how really that's kind of weird, but I like it. I like you. But then I was like, no, that's not a big deal. Not nearly as big of a secret as me talking to myself. like having full-on conversations. And none of that's as big of a deal as me sometimes climbing into my baby crib, since it's still in my room. But I wasn't ready to talk about that yet. What I really wanted to say, what I really wanted to tell him was something new, something fresh that I was holding in. I'm scared about tomorrow. About the track meet. That's what I told him. He asked, why? I told him I'm used to running the mile, and knowing that I will win, and when I do, I know I've made my team proud and made my mom proud. I knew I'd be putting that ribbon in his hand. But if for some reason tomorrow I don't do well, then I've let everybody down. Him, the team, my mother, everyone. Daryl set his fork down, his face stoning up in that serious way. He told me that he knows he hasn't been the kind of father that gives advice, but that he was going to give me some now. And then he said that when I step into that circle, and I do that weird spin, and I let that discus go, don't think about him, or the team, or even my mother. He told me to let it go for me. And that's where we'll stop for today. So there's a couple of cool little things I just wanted to mention really quickly before I let you guys go. So Sonny and Daryl had a conversation about why Daryl prefers to be called Daryl and not Dad by Sonny. Daryl says his reason that he likes to be called Dad is because he doesn't feel like it'd be fair to Sonny's mom, who passed away giving birth to Sonny. Daryl says he didn't think it'd be fair to be called Dad because she would never get to hear Sonny call her mom. And then Sonny was like, you know what, do you want me to call you to start calling you Dad now? And Daryl was like, no, you don't have to unless you want to. And Sonny was like, no, we'll keep it at Daryl. Daryl's fine. And then, so that was a secret that Daryl had shared with Sonny because Sonny was feeling a little uncomfortable at the dinner. And so Sonny, in return, had to share a secret of his. And so he told Daryl that he was a little afraid of his track meet tomorrow. He was afraid of letting everybody down, letting his coaches down, letting his mom down, letting his dad down, letting his teammates down. He didn't really want to do that. He was really worried and nervous about the meet. His dad gave him a really nice key piece of advice. Daryl puts his fork down and he looks right into Sonny's eyes and he says, when you step into that circle, don't think of anybody else. You don't think about me. You don't think about the team. You don't think about your mother. You don't think about the coaches. Think about yourself and only yourself. You do this for yourself and only yourself. And I think that that's what Sonny really needed to hear at this point, because remember, he didn't really care. He said himself that he didn't really care about winning so much, but he cared more so about doing this discus throw for other people in his life and making them proud. But he should be doing it for himself, right? And that's what Daryl wants him to help realize. And that's all I have for the reading today, guys. And that's actually, we're pretty close to being finished chapter 8 and the book. So we'll be probably pretty close to wrapping up the book here within the next couple weeks. So that's kind of exciting. I hope you guys enjoyed this little recording. Hope you enjoyed it being a little different. And I will see you guys for our live lesson tomorrow. Don't forget, it's from 11:30 to 12 p.m. tomorrow. You're accessing it on Microsoft Teams. And if you have any questions or concerns, or you maybe need help getting set up with that, shoot me an email or a comment, and I'll be glad to help you out. See you guys tomorrow.